Start. Good evening and welcome to this closing ceremony of our learning and development initiative, which is jointly done by Bombay Management Association and Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies. This Leader Next is a nomenclature that we had given this year because of the pandemic, and the pattern of our program has changed because of that. Last year, when we started, when Madam Chhaya Sehgal was the president of Bombay Management Association, that time we had initiated it as Leader 2020. The program is based on the recommendations of World Economic Forum. The recommendations are the skills required at the workplace in this decade of 2020. It's not only the knowledge, but the skills and people skills that are more important for being in the field and to become successful. JBIMS and Bombay Management Association decided to create a unique program which will cater to the needs of high performing, high potential employees of corporates. The first batch we conducted as Leader 2020, and the success of that, we thought that we must make it available online also, as all our activities since last year are going online. The nomenclature we created is Leader Next, which will be available for us in the next sessions also. I welcome Dr. Rajan Velukar, the current Vice Chancellor of Aurora University, Surat. And we all know Dr. Velukar had been the Vice Chancellor of University of Mumbai, Yashwantrao Chavan Mukta Vidyapeeth. He was also provost at the Somaiya Institute, Somaiya University, and has been very, very pro development in education and academic sector. A very well-known personality. He is here today to bless us. I welcome all the past presidents, Professor RSS Mani, Madam Chhaya Sehgal, my colleagues from academia, and the participants of this program, Leader Next, and the members of Bombay Management Association who have joined today for this closing ceremony. I will request Professor RSS Mani. When we started this Leader Next series, that time Professor RSS Mani was the president of Bombay Management Association. Under his leadership, under his guidance, we had modified, we have added some courses in this Leader Next avatar of Leader 2020. I will request Professor RSS Mani to give his comments about the program and also bless the participants who had been part of this Leader Next program. Over to you, Professor Mani.
Namaskar, everybody, and thank you, Kavita, for all those good words. A very warm welcome to our guest of honor, Dr. Rajan. And I can see some of our very senior faculty, including Mr. Vivek Paranjpe, present here this evening. It's indeed an honor to have you here with us this evening. Good evening to Chhaya, whom I believe, along with Dr. Murtaza Khurakiwala, actually conceived this program about 3 years ago. And this is what I guess leadership is all about. Leadership is all about continuity. And as Kavita rightly said, if we had to migrate from Leader 2020 to Leader Next, it just meant one thing, that successful leaders should have the ability to cope with changing times, embrace it, and take it one step ahead. I'm sure, along with all our distinguished faculty who have given you deep insights into various topics that you all have discussed over the last couple of months, you would have learned so many wonderful aspects of leadership, both personal leadership and leadership at the workplace. I'd like to take this opportunity to particularly thank each one of the faculty who I guess very quickly adapted from the physical training room, classroom kind of a scenario into the digital delivery of all these sessions. And I think all of us in academics will realize it's a huge exercise in unlearning, relearning, and yet trying to be as effective in the classroom. Compliments to Kavita and the entire team who stitched this whole initiative in the new avatar, as she said, and built up this program for the benefit of all of you. I'd like to just make two comments based on my experiences. I would believe a true leader is one who not only has sufficient followers, but has the courage and conviction to produce more leaders. This is the true test of leadership. All of us know that in the corporate world, we all dream for higher level promotions. We all want to be on the top of the rung of the organization. But as a leader, just think for a minute. If you want growth, have you developed somebody to take over from you when you grow on to the next step in the ladder? And I think this is one fundamental which is very often missed out by a lot of senior people in organizations. So for me, leadership is all about developing more leaders. And if you look at professional organizations like the Bombay Management Association and several others, the leadership pipeline is almost defined 2 years in advance, with the vice president incumbent as president. And this gives in a continuity to the entire organization's functioning and making it more systematic. One personal quality I believe the leader has to always show without any exception is displaying sound character and compassion. I'm not going to spend time defining these. I'm sure all of us have our own intrinsic definitions about character. But I would believe, simply put, character is our sanskar. And I believe this is the true test of leadership. And I'm sure every one of us in this room realizes the role of compassion and its importance after having lived through this journey called the pandemic due to Corona. I'm sure this is something most of us have been sensitized to. On that note, considering that we have someone like Dr. Rajan, who is truly an inspirational leader in the field of academia, a person who has walked the talk and has demonstrated how institutions can be built and how leaders can play a constructive role in institution building. It's going to be a delight to listen to him. Congratulations to all those who have completed this batch successfully. And I would believe this should not be called the concluding ceremony of this batch, but the launching ceremony of the next batch. Because if you think this program has helped you, please go back and share it with your colleagues so that Kavita and team can launch the next batch digitally. And hopefully, with times being better, we can pass them out physically. On that optimistic note, may I wish you all once again the very best of luck. And we look forward to interacting with you in time to come. Namaskar.
Thank you. Thank you for those nice words, Mani sir. As always, we feel very comfortable when you are saying that it is going to happen. And your words, we are seeing in reality also what you have predicted that is happening. So I'm sure with the success of this second batch of Leader Next, we are going to have another batch, which we will be starting soon. And for that, we need blessings of all of you who are here. Thank you. As mentioned by Professor R.S.S. Mani, that the thinking of this leadership series started when Professor Dr. Murtaza Khorakiwala was the president. And I remember all those meetings that we had in Wockhardt to create these modules, which are basically three. The first one is the core module, which is recommended by the World Economic Forum. We added to it two more, which is the people management and also the technology, because without technology, nowadays, the leadership will be a lame leadership. I remember Jagmohan Singh Rishi, Gururaj, Vaijayanti Naik, and then after some time we were joined with Shripad Ranade, and the team was led by none other than our own Ms. Chaya Sehgal. And with her mentorship, we could make lot of changes and lot of new initiatives in this program also. I welcome her and request her to say a few words about the journey that we have gone through for these two batches. Over to you.
Thank you, Kavita. Good evening, all. Welcome, Dr. Velukar. I still remember your infectious and enterprising speeches in the university a couple of times when I heard you. And I'm so happy you are here today to give them certificate and also enthrall them and inspire them with your speech a little later. So welcome. Thank you, Professor Mani, for those kind words. And welcome all the participants, all the dignitaries, Vivek Paranspe, one of our top faculties, and the other dignitaries. So Kavita asked me to recollect this journey, and any journey which has successful milestones is a pleasure to recall. We always have the memories. As humans, we also tend to keep all the other memories which we should not keep, but the one where we have successful milestones to look back upon, it is such a joy to recall those milestones. And yes, the beginning of it, as she said, you know, it happened about 3 years ago when Dr. Murtaza was at the helm of affairs, and I was a VP with him. And this is when we began, you know, thinking, visualizing, and then, you know, getting JBIMS on board. And the reason was very simple, that BMA was the first management association of India as a thought leader, and JBIMS was also the first management institute with Indian ethos, which was set up. The principle and the philosophy behind BMA as an association to be set up was also to promote the Indian ethos in management, and so was the case with JBIMS. So we decided to partner, and once we decided on that, then automatically the entire leadership at the implementation stage went to Kavita, who was the director then and the executive committee member at that time. Of course, a lot of faculty members came over the last 2 to 3 years, and everybody has contributed towards getting them on board. Every year, the president, whoever was the president, was responsible for getting more and more faculty members on board who proved to be just apt, and also full of wisdom and knowledge for our participants, which is so very visible from their feedback that we received from time to time. And the Leader 2020, the questioning that we did when we envisioned the program, had to be within a year evolved to something else, because nobody knew that Corona was coming. But the pandemic did come. And come to think of it, that is the test of leadership. When you have to encounter something that you have not been able to visualize, the uncertainty for which you could not have planned, and if you still come up trumps, then that is the testimony of your leadership. And the testimony of this program has emerged through all that, because the adaptability that was shown to adapt this program design, the pedagogy and the contents and everything to suit the new normal was almost automatic. And it hardly took any time to do so. And as a result, the new online version, which was now titled Leader Next, went through with as much rigor, with as much anticipation, and with as much value add as the first batch that was launched with Leader 2020. I really wish to acknowledge Dr. Murtaza, who has stood by us right from envisioning and guiding to launching the program, and also nominating candidates from VOCARD through all the two batches. And we hope to continue receiving his patronage throughout this program. This year again, we had some outstanding candidates. We have so many corporates to thank, you know, the US Vitamin for that matter, the SBI Caps, SBI General Insurance, and also SBI by itself. Many corporates joined in. I really hope many more corporates join in next year. We had some amazing session because one advantage of going digital was to be able to access the best regardless of where they came from. And in that perspective, we were able to have Mr. Mohandas Pai, Mr. Ashish Bhaseen, Ritu Anand of TCS, and Deepali Nair of IBM, and all these great speakers to come and speak through the second batch. And this was the privilege of the second batch. I mean, just as they would have missed the physical classrooms, let me remind them that there is something else where they gained compared to the earlier batch, that they could actually have all these eclectic leaders come and share their experiences, which certainly added a lot of value and excitement to this entire process of classroom teaching and learning as well. The real test of leadership is our ability to hold the two contrasts together and still find a direction which creates the value for all stakeholders. So it's like, you know, deciding between a decentralized setup versus a controlled setup, deciding between, HR and the marketing, finance and the IT, deciding between the technology and the people. So artificial intelligence or human intervention for innovation. So these are various contrasts, and these are various conflicting areas through which a leader is supposed to wade through and create a direction where the institution that he or she is leading finds a way to progress sustainably, grow, scale up, and also add value to all the stakeholders as they decide, as they desire. And I guess this program has been able to do that, because the kind of transformation that we have seen within 1 year, that gives me, as a mentor, a lot of confidence that we can continue reinventing ourselves, re-innovating ourselves, recreating ourselves, and re-questioning ourselves, whether Corona or anything else that comes our way. It just doesn't matter, because ultimately, a program which is on leaders and leadership building, if this cannot test, last the test of leadership, then what can? So, of course, it is going to work. Next year, we look forward to much more creative, a much more newer, much more fantastic version of it. And with that, I wish all the participants the very best. And I hope that now onwards, they will be the brand ambassadors of this program, wherein they have spent a few months and they have got so much to learn and practice and see the goodness that it creates and the support that it gives them while they lead on their respective desks in the organization, that with their being the brand ambassador of this program, their being the alumni of this program, we can look forward to now much stronger, much broader, and a much deeper learning next year with a much bigger batch. So with that, I would like to congratulate everybody once again, whoever is associated with the program, and I'd like to congratulate all the students who are going to today receive the certificates from the hands of the Honorable VC, Mr. Velukar. Thank you, Kavita. I take everybody's leave and over to all of you.
Thank you for those words. We can remember the flow in which we had created these. And I'm sure Guru Raj, who was there along with us as a faculty also, will remember all those meetings that we had. So I must thank all the resource persons who had been part of our journey. As I mentioned, Guru Raj Rao, Shri Vivek Paranjpe, Mr. Dexter Wallace. And this year we had invited Ashish Jha, who is also with us. There were many who had come to take sessions. This year, we had added storytelling, we had added some fireside chats, which was in form of leader speak series. And I think those leader speak series had really given eye-opening input to our leadership program. We are very thankful to all our resource person who had been very, very instrumental in delivering what we had thought as a program. And I thank them all for being with us and request them that we are going to launch the leader next program for the next batch. And we will get back to you once again for coming to this program once again. We have some representation from the participants also. So I will request Rajesh to start. He can give his perspective about this program. There were 14 participants for this leadership development program, and we will listen to few of them. What is their take on this journey that way they had with us? Over to you, Rajesh.
Good evening to every one of you. I just with one intention, I joined this program that I will learn something about it. Okay, overall the program was very good, along with the personal, professional growth, personal part also focused, like you need to be empathetic in dealing with your colleagues and outside people or whoever it may be, like setting up a personal vision, etc. Okay. Learned many things of like problem solving and all methods of problem solving, different methods like 6-3-5 methods of problem solving. And one thing I learned most that you cannot be a last user to use technology. If you have to embrace the technology if you want to succeed. In current situation, it is the need of the hour. Like data plays a very crucial role that I learned from the many of the methods that faculties were explained. One thing I understood that extraordinary people are not born, you know, not need to be a born extraordinary. Leaders are the person who creates the leaders who do an ordinary man do extraordinary things. That's it, and like to thank Bombay Management Association, General Bajaj Institute of Management Studies, all faculties, Kavita ma'am, and last but not least, Hoimi. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Rajesh. I'll request Rajnikant to say a few words.
Yeah, good evening all. Thank you, Kavita ma'am. You're able to listen to me, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So it has been a wonderful, I think, 6 to 7 months journey, learning journey after a very, very long time for me. So while being in a professional working place, we do have trainings, but normally they are for a few days and maybe maximum a week and all. But this journey of 6 months, while it is only twice a week, the kind of topics that are covered in the training session, the program, entire Leader Next program itself is worth mentioning. If you ask me, it covers two parts. One, on the latest things which are happening, covering the digitalization, innovation, data analytics, decision making. While on the personal side, the leadership topics like critical thinking, as you told, storytelling is one of the important thing for to be a successful leader, to drive your teams, etc. EQ and lot of speakers who have lot of experience has helped us a lot in terms of up to mark in terms of current environment, etc. It has been a wonderful, wonderful journey for 6 months. As Chaya ma'am has told that if it have been physical, maybe I would not have joined this program, but for online, it helped me for me to spare some time from the busy schedule. I could join this program, and maybe that is, I was lucky enough because as I heard that there are a lot of speakers because of online program you could bring to this, this session where we could get a lot of knowledge and like Mr. Mohandas Pai, Ritu Anand, and more people have come. So it's a wonderful program. I would like to thank JBMS and BMA for bringing this, and definitely I would like to recommend this to the next to be leaders, maybe in my organization, and also to my known friends, etc. So I wish all the best for the program, for the next batch, and that's it. Thanks a lot. Thanks to entire faculty also, and especially you, ma'am, for being there in every program, every class. Thanks a lot.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Rajnikant. I'll request MBN to say a few words. Unmute.
Yeah. Am I audible now?
Yes.
Yeah, good evening to all. First of all, I should thank Bombay Management Association for this wonderful program. As Rajnikant was mentioning, I tried joining the first program, but because of the physical classes, I could not join. One of the good things that could happen during the pandemic was this, you know, attending this, the LeaderNex program, the batch 2. So thanks for this opportunity. And in fact, I should thank the entire team who had designed this program on the concepts of core skills, ikigai, and digitalization. And this is very much essential during the VUCA world. And in fact, the kind of faculty we had were world-class. I still remember the personal vision sessions taken by Sripad, then the emotional question, the critical thinking, cognitive diversity, guest speakers, especially the guest speakers, all top class people. In fact, you know, a lot of learning, and the way that the classes were conducted and the commitment, which I could see from BMA and also from the faculty was very much appreciable. And really, I learned a lot. And in fact, while preparing for the presentation, when I looked at what is it I have learned and what is it I have implemented, I could really see a change in me happening during the course and after the course. Really, thank you so much for this opportunity to learn this course, especially to the BMA team and Kavita ji. Thank you so much. And I have already started talking about this program. I'm sure that I'll be able to bring on people who are the leaders in making. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sambian. I'm sure all the participants must be feeling the same. We had 14, but it will be not right to go for each and everyone's comment because of the time constraint that we have. Thank you all the participants for being with us. It was difficult to meet every week 2-3 times and then do the exercises that were given by the faculties. And we had a lot of diversity in the content. One was related to Ikigai, people management, then technology and data analytics and core subjects like that. But you have sailed through these 6-7 months. I know the pressure at the workplace, the responsibilities at the family of the family, and on top of it, these sessions of LeaderNex was really a challenge, and all of you have overcome that. Today we have with us a very known academician and a leader in academia, Dr. Rajan Velukar. He needs no introduction because all of us in Mumbai, we are aware that Dr. Velukar was Vice Chancellor of University of Mumbai from 2010 to 2015. A statistician by education, but he looks at the things very differently. He will see into the statistics and physics together, or statistics and many other things together. Before being the Vice Chancellor of University of Mumbai, Dr. Velukar was Vice Chancellor of Yashwant Rao Chavan Mukta Vidyapeeth, YCMOU, which has lot many students from all over Maharashtra, and how to give the education to the deprived class who are not able to join the regular face-to-face mode. Dr. Velukar has made lot of changes in YCMOU. It's not only academics, but also the vision to give them the understanding about how they can create opportunities for themselves. His initiatives at YCMOU, which were related to agriculture and entrepreneurship, are now also remembered. In University of Mumbai, he was not only the head of the organization, but he was like a father to the whole organization. The type of work during his tenure was done, we are all proud of being part of it. Not only the academics, but two Congress, that means History Congress and Indian Science Congress, where we got almost 18,000 participants from all over India and 14 Nobel laureates from all over the world to address the participants. I am very happy that we got a lot of opportunity during the tenure of Dr. Veyukar, and Jamnalal Bajaj, to be more precise, has got autonomy and the direction to think about the educational institute, which is in management. Dr. Veyukar, after his tenure at the University of Mumbai, joined Somaiya University as a provost. After that, he has been to Raisoni University as vice chancellor, and now he is heading the university in Gujarat, in Surat, which is called as Oro University. Very different field, but then sir will definitely make his mark there, and he always has many ideas, and we all have experienced at JBIMS also that the amalgamation and the thought that he will create out of two or more things will be very, very different. And today I'm very excited that he has agreed to talk to our participants of Leader Next, a true leader who is going to address us for the way ahead. As Professor Mani has said, that let's not call it a closing ceremony, but the beginning ceremony. I think the career that will begin from here will be different, and I hope that will benefit all of us. I'm happy, sir, you have accepted our invitation to address these participants of Leader Next. And thank you for taking time out in spite of your busy schedule. And I will request you to address the participants for the Leader Next program. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Kavita Lagate, the director of Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies, Professor R.S.S. Mani, who spoke before me, before Dr. Kavita, Professor Vivek Paranspe, all the faculties, experts in management, management science or management studies, whatever you call it, invitees, and my dearest learners, I would say, and every one of us are learners. In fact, I don't know why I have been invited. I am the most odd man out in this entire group. I have never studied management studies or management science, nor I have read a lot of books which you might have read or you might have practiced in the corporate sector or whichever organization you are in. But I consider this as an opportunity for me to learn from all of you. Because when you are invited, you have to listen to other people. And when other people speaks, you get a different angle and some different ideas from all of you. And therefore, I am here, whether it is the fresh student or the resource person. So thank you very much, Dr. Kavita, for giving me an opportunity to be with all of you. First, I compliment and congratulate Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies and BMA Bombay Management Association for coming together, which is very, very important, and launching this course, which is need of the hour. Congratulations to both of you and the team of both the organization. At the same time, I congratulate all the students, those who are graduating. Graduating means you have graduated to the next level. Graduating means doesn't mean that you have achieved a UG degree or PG degree or PhD degree, but you have graduated to the next level by learning something which you were unaware of. And therefore, I say congratulations to each one of you for graduating to the next level. I have gone through the content of the course which you are teaching. When I had gone through the content, I myself thought that I should have joined this course so that I would have learned something out of this, which I have not learned in my formally, in a formal way. I have not learned in my school or college or even my career. Informally, yes, one learns. And I tried and learned something, but I felt that systematically, if you want to learn something, you should definitely join some or the other course like this. So I was tempted when I had gone through the course. Anyway, I missed that. And in fact, I would not be able to attend because of my this thing. But it is such a wonderful course you have created. And I'm sure with the feedback of students, they also must be having some feedback which they want to give for the course. So you may add or subtract some of the topics, or you may change the pedagogy and the delivery system if at all needed. But one request to all the participants is you must write the reflections. Those reflections will be the feedback to the faculty members and to the institution so that they can make necessary changes in whatever they have. So reflections are the most important thing. And those who learn through reflections, they only learn, others don't. This is what I have arrived to. If I don't reflect, I don't learn. I may memorize, but I am not learning. If I am reflecting, I am learning. And when you reflect, you become more responsive. When you are not reflecting, then you become reactive. And if you want to be a leader next, then remember that you should not be reactionary, but you should be responsive. The leader of the 21st century has to be responsive. If you are not responsive, if you are not responding to any situation, then you are not a leader. You are a manager. You are managing that situation, but you are not leading that organization to the next level. And therefore, I say that learn to reflect. Through reflection, you will learn to respond. And the moment you respond, you become the leader next. That is what is coming to my mind at this juncture. I am writing one article and sending it for publication. The title of the article is, "We have a lot of potential, but we are not achieving it." All the time, India is saying in the modern world that we have the potential. And we, if we don't want to continue saying this, that we have the potential, we need to go to the next level, and that next level is of realization. There is a gap between potentiality and actuality. Now, if we want to bring the gap between the potentiality and the actuality, then you will have to learn to realize that realization has to come. So I am writing an article from that angle. How do we reduce the gap between the potentiality and the actuality? How do we realize it? And from that angle, you need to understand the leadership next. And therefore, you need to do research and you need to learn a skill. I say this, I am saying since 2004. Whether you learn the skills which are taught or not, you have to learn that. There is no go. And those skills will be changing. And over a period of time, you will have to learn those skills. But the only sustainable skill which one will have to learn, and especially the leader next has to learn, and that skill is intellectual alertness. If you are not intellectual alertness, you will not be able to respond to the situations which will come in your life or in your organization or in your nation. See, during this pandemic, because we were not intellectual alert, the whole world, it took a lot of time for all the nations to respond. Everybody was reacting and everybody was trying trial and error method, because they have not anticipated this. In the afternoon, I was talking to the hospitality industry, some of the COOs, chief operating officers of the hospitality industry, those who are managing 40 hotels, five-star hotels, and more than that. And I asked them, were you prepared for this situation? Did you expected that this is going to happen? Was it there in your plan that if this happens, then what are you going to do? He said, we never thought about this. And why they have not thought about it? Because they were not intellectually alert. They never anticipated that this is going to happen. When in the world, since last 30 to 40 years, people are talking about biological war. I don't say that this is a biological war, but this was certainly a situation of biological war. And therefore, the leadership next will have to remember that they will have to learn the skill which is of intellectual alertness. The drivers will change. The present, there are drivers like rise of smart machines and systems, the computational world, the new media ecology, then superstructured organizations, then globally connected world. These are the drivers presently. In addition to that, this pandemic, the drivers will change from time to time. And when these drivers are changed, you need to anticipate those drivers. For that, you need to be intellectually alert. Different skills at different times one will have to learn. Like Macaulay's purpose was different. He wanted that Indians should learn those specific skills so that those children will be useful to the Britishers in their administration, in their governance system. Now the industries are talking about something else. We need these skills. But we need to transfer the sustainable skills which the future leaders will need. From time to time, yes, certain skills they will have to learn, but we need to go beyond the certain skills. We need to teach them the skills which are sustainable. for which we need to understand the vertical literacy. That is what we are talking in education. What is vertical literacy in higher education? And vertical literacy in higher education is from self to society. Unless and until we understand self to society, whether it is higher education or industry, if we don't understand, then we will not be able to live sustainable life. And therefore, we need to think very, very differently. So I was just thinking, what are the elements, five elements, which this leadership next must understand and must know. And these five elements, as we remember Agni, Vayu, and all those five elements. So similarly, in this leadership next, I feel you should remember these five elements in for the leadership next. And that is, number one is employ your circular vision. If you want to understand this circular vision, you can understand this circular vision from the most beautiful equation in mathematics, which is having five elements. It is e to the power I pi plus 1 is equal to 0. 0 is unique, 1 is unique, I is unique, pi is unique, e is unique. There is no equation till today in mathematics having all these five elements, which are very, very different, which has transformed the world. So similarly, the education leadership next will need this thing. One is you should have a circular vision. And that circular vision will give you an inside angle, which will give you that circular vision to anticipate the crisis, as this pandemic was a crisis, Corona, COVID-19, and manage change. Because change is mandatory, survival is optional. And if you want to survive, and if in your option, the survival, if you opt for, then you will have to learn the intelligent alertness. So the first element for leadership next is this: have a circular vision. The second element is unleash your passionate pursuits. The leader will have to unleash the passionate pursuit. Then only you will be able to drive your organization. Then only you will be able to drive whatever you want to bring the changes in. That is, always strive for excellence. So remember, this is the second element which I feel you should have. And therefore, the leadership should always inspire and motivate through their own passion and commitment. If you don't have the passion, and if you are not inspiring and motivating your team members, your associates, then you are not a leader next. This is the second element. The third element is live with entrepreneurial spirit. Always you must have that entrepreneurial spirit. And by nature, you should be entrepreneur. Then only you can become the leader next. And this is the third element. The fourth element is work with generous purpose. Your purpose has to be generous. Whichever organization you are in, your purpose has to be inclusive. You should be able to transform the lives of everybody which are there in your circle. You be inclusive. And therefore, for that, you have to be generous. So your purpose has to be generous. That is what you should remember. And you should always work for everybody's best interest. If you work for everybody's best interest, then only you are doing justice, or else you are not doing justice to the organization and to your employee. So these are the four elements, and the fourth one, that is the skill of intellectual alertness. The moment you have this five skill, then you can become the leader next. That is what I feel, and that is what came to my mind today, just to give a message. But I must compliment, as I have said, I'm not from management. I'm the odd man out, but whatever came to my mind, I just spoke. And I must thank Dr. Kavita and the Bombay Management Association, Deepa and Dr. RSS Mani, and everybody those who's involved in this, for giving me an opportunity to be part of this program. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. And at the same time, I thank all of you, all the students and invitees, and everybody those who are attending this program, for listening to me or hearing to me. Whatever you have done, there is a difference between the two. So thank you very much, and my best wishes to all of you for getting the success of going to the next step and graduating. Thank you very much, and my best wishes to all of you.
Thank you, sir. As always, it is very inspiring, and your 5 points we will remember. The unique equation that you have mentioned, that has all the unique characters or with the constants of mathematics that you have mentioned, we will remember that also. Now it is the time where we will be flashing the certificates of all our participants. I will request the secretariat to share the screen to display the certificates which we have created for the participants. Are we ready?
Mom, are you able to see my screen?
Yes, we are able. So the certificates are for certificate of completion to Sembiyan Balasubramanian. Congratulations, Sembiyan. Next.
Thank you.
Certificate of completion is awarded to Rajesh Pujari. Rajesh, congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am.
Certificate of completion is awarded to Ashish Jawdekar. My congratulations to Ashish also. Certificate of completion is awarded to Sandeep Khairnar. Congratulations to Sandeep. Certificate of completion is awarded to Manohar Gharat. My congratulations and compliments to Manohar. Certificate of completion is awarded to Vishwanath Vaidya. Vishwanath, congratulations. Certificate of completion is awarded to Amit Mahamunkar. Congratulations, Amit. Certificate of completion is awarded to Shenava Uma Shankar, and I must compliment him, because in spite of the senior being senior, he was very, very interactive, and he has enjoyed and he has attended all the sessions. So a special mention of Uma Shankar ji for being as young student of this group. So thank you for being with us.
Thank you so much.
Yes. Congratulations to Rajnikant Memory for completing this Leader Next program. Rajnikant, congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am.
Certificate of completion is awarded to Praveen Niyogi. Congratulations to Pradeep. Certificate of completion is awarded to Aditya Mahajan. Aditya, congratulations. Certificate of completion is awarded to Vinayak Joshi. Congratulations, Vinayak. Certificate of completion is awarded to Nitin Badana. Best wishes and compliments to Nitin. And certificate of completion is awarded to Candy for his completion and best wishes to him for the next level.
Thank you. Thank you, madam.
Thank you.
That's it, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you, Lakshmi. A moment of achievement, the moment of satisfaction is here. After completing almost 6 months every week, Wednesdays and Saturdays, sometimes 4.5 hours, sometimes more than that, we have completed this task. And there were many learnings that we had. Thanks are due to the team who curated it, which was including Jagmohan Rishi, Vaijayanti Naik, Guru Raj Rao, Shripad Ranade, Chaya Madam. All of them, they have very meticulously curated it. The feedback of our resource persons who were part of our Leader 2020 program had made us to modify and adapt to the situation and improve upon the product that we had offered. All the resource persons who were part of Leader 2020 and Leader Next, it is because of you that we could deliver. Thinking was one part, but I think delivering to the satisfaction of all the participants and to the organizations, I think was a big task. We had relied upon you and you had done a marvelous job. Thank you very much for being with us and hope that you will be with us for our next program also. The organizations who had believed in us and given their employees and their participants to these programs, thanks are due to those organizations who had been very supportive to BMA for such kind of leadership development program, which is unique in itself. The participants who had made it to the every week, every day, after the work hours, on a holiday to attend, I appreciate their dedication. I appreciate their drive for learning. And I'm sure all these sessions that we had must have touched some chord of our lives, some chord of our heart, which will remind you to make use of it. Unless we apply, it will not be a circle complete. We will have to complete the circle by actually applying it. I'm sure you must have thought how you are going to translate these learnings, reflect and respond, as our guest of honor had said, and will make most of it for yourself and your organization. The BMA secretariat, who was very alert and was very, very supportive in this initiative. I must thank all the girls from secretariat and specifically Hoimi, who was handling this particular initiative. All the past presidents, specifically Professor R.S.S. Mani and Madam Chaya Sehgal, I can't forget, because it's their guidance and their leadership that we could create these initiatives and interact with the corporates at a different level. I am happy that my colleagues from JBIMS were always there, and they had also attended the program. And I am sure the Leader Speak series, which we had got in this particular Leader Next version, has benefited all of us. We could interact with people who are at the top of their career, and they are seen as the leading personality, and we were benefited by that. All these things that we did for last 6 months are going to be with us through the physical certificate, which we will be delivering to you at your given addresses. But be with Bombay Management Association for such kind of initiatives. You are all aware that every Wednesdays and every Fridays, we come up with Wednesday Wisdom Webinar and Friday Fundamentals and bring to you various speakers, various topics of our interest, which will benefit all of us. The next coming up is on Friday, a conclave on data analytics, where we will have a speaker from academia, Dr. Chandrasekhar, a CEO of a data analytics company, Ms. Uma, and we have a software which is now available in India, Zoho, who is our partner also. Do join us on Friday at 4:30 to be part of Data Analytics Conclave of Bombay Management Association. Thank you all for joining for this closing ceremony, and join us to the Data Analytics Conclave on Friday. Subscribe to Bombay Management Association YouTube channel. We are very active. There are more than 1,000, almost 1,000 subscribers to Bombay Management Association's YouTube. There are over 180 interesting videos that are uploaded, and you get every week a pick of the week which you can listen to. Thank you. Thank you for being with us for this closing ceremony. We'll stop here, and hoping that you will join us for all other programs and value add to the association, Bombay Management Association. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, and all the best to all of you.
Thank you, Ashish ji, for joining. Thank you, Vivek sir, for joining. Dexter sir, thank you.
Thank you.
Guru Raj, thank you.